Few stories capture the imagination and stir the soul quite like the epic saga of the 12 apostles of Jesus. These were ordinary men called to an extraordinary mission, a mission that would lay the foundation for the world's largest faith and forever alter the course of human history. Welcome everyone to a journey back in time, to the very roots of Christianity, as we explore the monumental lives and the heroic deaths of these remarkable individuals. The apostles were more than just followers. They were the carriers of a message that would ignite hearts and minds across continents and generations. Tasked with spreading the teachings of Jesus, they traversed hostile lands, faced unimaginable dangers, and spoke to hearts in a language that transcended borders and cultural barriers. Their mission was not merely to preach, but to embody a message of love, sacrifice, and redemption that was revolutionary in its simplicity and profound in its impact. But who were these men? What drove them to leave everything behind and follow a path fraught with peril? And how did their journeys conclude? These questions beckon us to delve into each apostle's story, to uncover the trials they endured and the sacrifices they made. From Peter's crucifixion upside down to Thomas's missionary journeys to India, from the stoning of Matthias to John's exile on the island of Patmos, each tale is a testament to faith, courage, and an unyielding commitment to a cause greater than oneself. So join us as we embark on this voyage through time, tracing the steps of these foundational figures of Christianity. Through their stories, we'll discover not just the roots of a global faith, but the enduring power of belief and the indomitable spirit of those who are willing to lay down their lives for what they hold true. This is the story of the 12 apostles of Jesus, their legacy that continues to inspire, and the eternal lessons their lives teach us about faith, sacrifice, and the transformative power of love. Let's begin. The context of apostolic missions. As the dawn of the first century broke over the Roman Empire, the world was a crucible of cultures, religions, and political power. It was into this world that the apostles stepped, armed with nothing but the teachings of Jesus and a conviction that would shake the foundations of history. The Roman Empire, known for its unparalleled roads and sprawling cities, was also a place where political dissent and religious deviation were met with iron and blood. The Pax Romana, a so-called peace achieved and maintained through suppression and force, was the backdrop against which the gospel began its spread. The apostles embarked on their missions in a society stratified by class, ethnicity, and religion, navigating a labyrinth of Jewish tradition, Roman law, and pagan rituals. Their message of a crucified and risen Messiah was radical, challenging both the Jewish expectation of a conquering hero and the Roman cult of emperor worship. As Paul writes in 1 Corinthians 1:23, "We preach Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles." Yet it was this message, so discordant with the prevailing norms, that they were compelled to share. The dangers they faced were not abstract. Preaching the gospel meant challenging the status quo, inciting the wrath of both religious and secular authorities. The book of Acts is replete with accounts of persecution, beatings, imprisonments, riots, and trials before governors and kings. Stephen's stoning, Acts 7:54-60, Peter and John's imprisonment, Acts 4:1-3, and Paul's numerous brushes with death underscore the perils inherent in their mission. The Roman Empire, with its pantheon of gods and established religious practices, viewed the exclusivity of the Christian claim to truth as subversive, a threat to the social order and imperial authority. Yet despite these immense challenges, the apostles pressed on with a courage that can only be described as supernatural. Their commitment to spreading the teachings of Jesus knew no bounds. They traversed deserts, sailed treacherous seas, and walked through hostile cities to bring the light of the gospel to every corner of the known world. Their perseverance in the face of persecution set a profound example for all believers. Embodying Jesus' teachings in Matthew 5:11-12, "Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven." This unwavering commitment, even unto death, laid the foundation for the accounts of their martyrdoms, each a story not of defeat, but of ultimate victory. As we explore these narratives, we are reminded of the cost of discipleship and the power of faith that transcends even the darkest circumstances. The Apostles' journey is a testament to the transformative power of the Gospel, a beacon of hope that continues to sheen across millennia, calling each of us to a faith that endures, a love that sacrifices, and a truth that liberates. The Apostles' final missions and deaths. Peter. As we delve into the stories of the Apostles' final missions and their ultimate sacrifices, we begin with Peter, a figure whose journey from a humble fisherman to the cornerstone of the early church encapsulates the transformative power of faith and leadership. Peter's role in the nascent church cannot be overstated. Christ himself, in a moment of profound revelation, bestowed upon Peter a name and a mission that would define the future of Christianity. "And I tell you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it." Matthew 16:18. Peter embraced this calling with a fervor and dedication that saw him leading the early believers through times of uncertainty and peril. From his bold proclamation at Pentecost, which added 3,000 souls to the church, Acts 2:41, to his miraculous escape from Herod's prison, Acts 12:5-17, Peter's leadership was characterized by a steadfast trust in God and an unyielding commitment to the gospel. Yet, it was in Rome, the heart of the empire and a burgeoning center for the Christian faith, that Peter would face his greatest challenge. Tradition holds that Peter journeyed to Rome, ministering to the Christian community there and continuing his mission of spreading the teachings of Jesus amidst a climate of increasing hostility. Rome, under Emperor Nero, became a place of extreme persecution for Christians, who were blamed for the Great Fire of Rome and subjected to gruesome tortures and deaths. Peter's final act of witness came in the form of his own martyrdom. According to early Christian tradition, Peter was crucified under Nero's reign. But in a final testament to his humility and his desire to not equate himself with Jesus, Peter requested to be crucified upside down. This act of martyrdom, while a moment of profound sorrow, also served as a powerful declaration of faith, a signal to all believers of the lengths to which the apostles would go in their devotion to Christ. Peter's death was not an end but a beginning, a laying down of the foundation upon which the church would continue to grow and spread across the world. His life, leadership, and sacrifice echo through the centuries, reminding us of the cost of discipleship and the enduring power of faith. Peter's story is a call to courage, to steadfastness, and to the unwavering belief in the promise of Christ, that upon this rock he would build his church, and not even the gates of Hades would prevail against it. James the Greater. Following the narrative of Peter's profound legacy, we turn our gaze to James the Greater, whose destiny would mark another pivotal moment in the early Christian church. James, one of the first disciples Jesus called to follow him, bore witness to Christ's transfiguration and was a pillar in the foundation of the church. Yet it was his death that underscored the burgeoning wave of persecution that would come to define the early Christian experience. James the Greater, so named to distinguish him from another apostle also named James, held a prominent role among the disciples. A son of Zebedee, he was part of the inner circle of Jesus, alongside Peter and his own brother John. This closeness to Jesus was a testament to James's fervor and dedication, traits that would carry him through his mission to spread the gospel. The book of Acts records the grim fate that befell James, making him the first of the apostles to be martyred. It was about this time that King Herod arrested some who belonged to the church, intending to persecute them. He had James, the brother of John, put to death with the sword, Acts 12:1-2. Herod Agrippa's decision to execute James by the sword in Jerusalem was a calculated move, aimed at curbing the spread of Christianity by striking down its leaders. James's martyrdom was not just a personal tragedy, but a symbol of the escalating conflict between the burgeoning Christian faith and the political and religious authorities of the time. James's death by the sword in Jerusalem marked a turning point, signaling the beginning of a period of intense persecution for the early Christians. This moment of violence against one of Jesus' closest followers served as a stark reminder of the cost of discipleship, the price of bearing witness to the truth of the gospel in a hostile world. Yet it also reinforced the apostles' unwavering commitment to their mission, willing to face death itself to spread the message of Christ. James's martyrdom, while a moment of profound loss, also became a beacon of faith, a testament to the strength and courage of those who follow Christ. His sacrifice illustrates the paradox at the heart of Christianity, that through death comes life and through sacrifice, a greater hope is born. James the Greater's story continues to inspire believers, a reminder of the enduring power of faith and the ultimate victory of the gospel, even in the face of persecution and death. John. In the shadow of martyrdom that enveloped his fellow apostles, John's journey offers a poignant contrast, embodying resilience and the power of faith to endure through trials and tribulations. Known as the beloved disciple, John's life and mission were marked not by the sword's edge, but by the pen's resilience and the spirit's fortitude, illustrating a different kind of witness to the gospel's enduring truth. Unlike James the Greater and Peter, John's final chapters were not written in the ink of martyrdom, but in the quiet defiance of survival against the odds. Tradition and early church history tell us of John's later years, where, despite surviving multiple attempts on his life, including being thrown into a cauldron of boiling oil from which he miraculously emerged unharmed, he continued his ministry with undiminished zeal. His resilience in the face of persecution underscored the varied paths the apostles' lives took, all converging towards the same enduring testament to their faith. John's exile to the island of Patmos, a rocky and desolate land, became the setting for one of the New Testament's most enigmatic and profound writings, the Book of Revelation. I, John, your brother and companion in the suffering and kingdom and patient endurance that are ours in Jesus, was on the island of Patmos because of the Word of God and the testimony of Jesus, Revelation 1-9. This exile meant as punishment transformed into a divine appointment, allowing John to pen a visionary text that has inspired and challenged believers for centuries. John's natural death, an outlier among the apostles who faced violent ends, speaks volumes of the diverse tapestry of apostolic witness. Living to an old age in Ephesus, John continued to guide and nurture the early Christian communities, his life a testament to the sustaining power of love and faith, amidst a world often hostile to the message he carried. His writings, including the Gospel of John, three epistles, and the Book of Revelation, contribute richly to Christian theology, emphasizing the depth of God's love, the person of Christ, and the hope of eternal life. John's story, marked by endurance rather than martyrdom, offers a compelling narrative of apostolic legacy. It reminds us that the witness to Christ's resurrection and lordship comes in many forms, through the lives given in death and equally through the lives lived in steadfast faith despite the shadows of death. John's journey from the banks of the Jordan to the rugged exile of Patmos and the quiet of his final days in Ephesus illustrates the profound truth that the light of the gospel cannot be extinguished, shining through persecution, trials, and the passage of time, a beacon of hope and truth for all generations. Andrew. Transitioning from the serene twilight of John's life, we venture into the story of Andrew, whose journey from the shores of Galilee to his final breath on an X-shaped cross encapsulates the essence of apostolic mission and martyrdom. Andrew, the brother of Peter and the first disciple called by Jesus, embarked on a path that led him far from the familiar waters where he first met the Messiah. His was a journey marked by fervent preaching, untiring missionary work, and a profound commitment to spreading the message of Christ to the ends of the earth. Andrew's missionary endeavors took him to the far reaches of the known world, from the shores of the Black Sea to the lands that would become modern-day Greece and Turkey. Tradition holds that Andrew brought the gospel to the Scythians, a people renowned in antiquity for their fierceness. His efforts to plant the seeds of faith in such diverse and often hostile territories testify to his unwavering dedication to Christ's commission to make disciples of all nations. However, it was in Patras, a city in the Greek Peloponnese, where Andrew's missionary journey would culminate in the ultimate act of witness to his faith. Confronted by the Roman authorities, Andrew was sentenced to die on a cross for his relentless preaching of the gospel. In a final testament to his humility and his desire to identify with the sufferings of Christ, yet not deem himself worthy to die in the same manner, Andrew was crucified on an X-shaped cross, a symbol that has come to be known as St. Andrew's Cross. Hanging from this cross, Andrew continued to proclaim the love and salvation found in Jesus Christ to all who would hear, until he breathed his last. His crucifixion on an X-shaped cross is not merely a detail of his martyrdom, but a powerful symbol of the apostle's profound connection to Christ and his gospel. It underscores the reality that the call to follow Jesus is a call to take up one's cross, to embrace suffering and sacrifice for the sake of the gospel, with the hope of resurrection and eternal life firmly in view. Andrew's legacy is one of courage, perseverance, and an unyielding commitment to the cause of Christ. His missionary journeys and his martyrdom on an X-shaped cross remind us of the cost of discipleship and the transformative power of the gospel to inspire such devotion. As we reflect on Andrew's life and death, we are challenged to consider our own response to Jesus's call to come, follow me, and to ponder the ways in which we too are called to bear witness to the light of Christ in a world in need of hope. Philip. After exploring the intrepid paths trodden by Andrew, our journey leads us to Philip, whose story unfolds across the rugged landscapes of Asia Minor. Philip, known for his role in early Christian evangelism, embarked on a mission imbued with zeal and a deep conviction in the transformative power of the gospel. His travels and teachings in Asia Minor, particularly in the ancient city of Hierapolis, present a vivid tableau of the challenges and triumphs faced by the early apostles. Philip's ministry in Asia Minor is marked by an unwavering commitment to spread the teachings of Jesus, navigating a region steeped in a rich tapestry of cultures and religious beliefs. Asia Minor, a crucial crossroads of the ancient world, was a melting pot of Hellenistic, Roman, and Eastern influences, presenting both a fertile ground for the gospel and a formidable challenge due to its entrenched pagan traditions and the Roman imperial cult. The climax of Philip's missionary work led him to Hierapolis, a city renowned for its thermal springs and as a center for pagan worship. It was here that Philip faced the ultimate test of his faith. According to early Christian tradition, Philip was martyred in Hierapolis for his unyielding dedication to the Christian faith. His martyrdom is said to have come about through a brutal death, where he was either crucified upside down or executed by beheading, a testament to the perilous conditions under which the apostles spread the message of Christ. Philip's death in Hierapolis not only signifies the profound sacrifices made by the apostles, but also underscores the potent clash between the emerging Christian faith and the prevailing religious and cultural norms of the time. Yet, it was through such sacrifices that the foundations of the church were strengthened. As the blood of martyrs became the seed of the church, nurturing the growth of Christianity even in the most inhospitable of conditions. Philip's legacy, marked by his missionary zeal and his ultimate sacrifice in Hierapolis, serves as a poignant reminder of the lengths to which the apostles went to bear witness to the gospel. His life and death illustrate the transformative impact of the apostolic missions, not only in terms of geographic spread, but in the hearts and minds of individuals across diverse cultures. Philip's story challenges us to reflect on the depth of our own faith and the extent to which we are willing to go in sharing the hope and love found in Jesus Christ. Bartholomew. From Philip's steadfast evangelism in Asia Minor, we turn to the enigmatic figure of Bartholomew, also known as Nathanael, whose missionary journeys and harrowing martyrdom echo the profound costs and far-reaching impacts of apostolic ministry. Bartholomew's travels spanned the breadth of the known world, from India to Armenia, showcasing the apostolic zeal that propelled the gospel beyond its Judaic cradle to the far corners of the earth. Bartholomew's missionary endeavors are marked by a commitment to carry the message of Christ across vast and diverse territories. In India, tradition holds that he left behind a copy of the Gospel of Matthew, sowing the seeds of faith in fertile ground. Moving westward, his mission took him through Greater Armenia, where he is credited with making significant conversions, laying the foundations for a Christian tradition that endures to this day. His travels underscore the apostles' dedication to the Great Commission, venturing into unknown lands to share the transformative power of the gospel. The culmination of Bartholomew's ministry, however, is marked by the manner of his martyrdom, a testament to the extreme sacrifices borne by the apostles. Various traditions recount the manner of his death, but the most vivid and enduring is that of his flaying in Armenia. Refusing to renounce his faith, Bartholomew was subjected to a gruesome death, skinned alive before ultimately being beheaded. This brutal end, though shocking, illustrates the intensity of the opposition faced by the apostles, and the lengths to which they would go to remain faithful to their calling. Bartholomew's martyrdom, particularly the imagery of being flayed, has become emblematic of the apostolic spirit, an unflinching willingness to endure the most severe persecutions for the sake of the gospel. His legacy, symbolized by the flaying knife often depicted in art, serves as a stark reminder of the cost of discipleship and the profound impact of the apostolic missions. Through Bartholomew's widespread travels and his ultimate sacrifice, we are reminded of the boundless reach of the gospel and the depth of conviction required to bear witness to its truth. His story challenges us to consider the depth of our own faith and commitment. In the face of adversity and opposition, Bartholomew's life and martyrdom stand as a beacon of courage, urging us to persevere in our mission, fortified by the knowledge that the message we carry has the power to transform the world. Matthew. Following the poignant narrative of Bartholomew's ultimate sacrifice, we transition to the story of Matthew, an apostle whose transformation from a tax collector to a fervent evangelist embodies the redemptive power of Christ's call. Matthew's journey from the margins of Jewish society to the heart of the early church's missionary efforts highlights a life radically changed by the gospel, a testament to the inclusive and transformative nature of Jesus's message. Matthew, also known as Levi, was called by Jesus from the tax booth, an occupation despised by his contemporaries for its associations with Roman oppression and corruption. This call to discipleship, captured in the gospel that bears his name, signifies the profound personal change that defines Matthew's story. "Follow me," Jesus said to him, and Matthew got up and followed him, Matthew 9:9. This pivotal moment marked the beginning of Matthew's journey from collecting dues to spreading the good news. Embracing his new calling, Matthew dedicated himself to the evangelistic mission, becoming one of the key figures in spreading Christianity among Jewish communities. His contribution to the Christian canon, the Gospel of Matthew, reflects not only his first-hand experience of Jesus' teachings and miracles, but also his deep understanding of Jewish law and prophecy, bridging the old and the new in a narrative that affirmed Jesus as the Messiah. Matthew's missionary work extended beyond the written word, taking him to various parts of the known world, including Ethiopia, Persia, and Macedonia. In these lands, he faced the daunting task of proclaiming the gospel to cultures steeped in their own traditions and gods, challenging the very fabric of their society with a message of redemption and a call to follow Christ. The culmination of Matthew's evangelistic efforts, however, was met with violence. Tradition holds that in Ethiopia, Matthew's insistence on the gospel's exclusivity and his denunciation of idolatry led to his martyrdom by the sword. This act of violence, while ending Matthew's earthly ministry, could not silence the message he had dedicated his life to spreading. Like his fellow apostles, Matthew's death underscored the dangerous reality of early Christian evangelism and the unwavering commitment of the apostles to their divine mission. Matthew's transition from tax collector to apostle, his evangelistic zeal, and his martyrdom by the sword collectively paint a vivid picture of the apostolic age, marked by radical transformations and the ultimate sacrifices made in the name of faith. His story encourages believers to recognize the power of Christ to change lives, calling us to embrace our mission with courage and conviction, regardless of the cost. In remembering Matthew, we are reminded of the enduring impact of the gospel message, a message that continues to call, transform, and challenge us to this day. Thomas. From the narrative of Matthew's dedicated evangelism and ultimate sacrifice, we now turn to the remarkable journey of Thomas, an apostle whose story intertwines doubt with profound faith and a missionary zeal that carried him to the shores of India. Known as Doubting Thomas for his initial disbelief in Jesus' resurrection, Thomas's story is a powerful testament to the transformative journey from doubt to unwavering faith, a journey that propelled him far beyond the familiar confines of the early Christian world. Thomas's initial moment of doubt, when he insisted on seeing the nail marks in Jesus' hands and placing his hand into Jesus' side before believing in the resurrection, is met with a gentle and revealing response from Jesus. "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." John 20:29. This pivotal encounter not only resolves Thomas's doubts, but deepens his faith, setting the stage for his subsequent missions. Emboldened by his renewed conviction, Thomas is traditionally believed to have traveled further than any of the other apostles, reaching the distant lands of India. His mission there was monumental, planting the seeds of Christianity in a soil rich with ancient religions and traditions. Thomas's work in India is marked by the establishment of Christian communities that would endure for centuries, a testament to the depth of his commitment to Christ's commission. The culmination of Thomas's missionary journey, however, was marked by martyrdom. Tradition holds that in Milapur, near modern-day Chennai, Thomas was martyred by a spear, his life claimed by those opposed to his preaching and the Christian faith he represented. This act of violence, while tragic, underscores the extent of Thomas's dedication to spreading the gospel, a mission he pursued with unwavering zeal even in the face of death. Thomas's death by spear in India not only signifies the far-reaching impact of the apostolic missions, but also highlights the individual apostles' profound transformation through their encounter with the risen Christ. His story, from doubt to faith, from Jerusalem to India, and from fear to martyrdom, serves as a compelling narrative of the Christian mission, characterized by radical faith and the global spread of the gospel. In reflecting on Thomas's mission and martyrdom, we are reminded of the universal call to faith and the power of the gospel to transcend cultural and geographic boundaries. Thomas's legacy, enshrined in the ancient Christian communities of India, invites us to embrace our doubts and fears as part of our journey of faith, encouraging us to witness boldly to the truth of the resurrection, even unto the ends of the earth. James the Less. We now turn our attention to James the Less, a figure whose steadfast leadership and tragic end deeply impacted the early Christian community. James the Less, often identified as the brother of the Lord, due to his close relationship with Jesus, played a pivotal role in the Jerusalem church, serving as a bridge between the Jewish traditions and the burgeoning Christian faith. As the leader of the Jerusalem church, James the Less was renowned for his wisdom and devotion. He was a man of strong convictions, deeply rooted in the Jewish customs, yet fully committed to the message of Jesus Christ. His leadership was characterized by an unwavering commitment to the unity of the church and a deep compassion for the poor and marginalized. James's epistle, attributed to him in the New Testament, emphasizes the importance of faith manifested through works, particularly the care for those in need, a reflection of his own life and ministry. James's position, however, placed him at the nexus of religious and cultural tensions in Jerusalem, a city teeming with political unrest and religious fervor. His efforts to navigate these tumultuous waters, advocating for a faith that transcended traditional Jewish laws without abandoning the heritage of his people, eventually led to his martyrdom. According to Josephus, the first century Jewish historian, and other early Christian sources, James's steadfast preaching of Jesus as the Messiah and his refusal to denounce his faith led to his tragic death. The accounts describe how James was taken to the pinnacle of the temple during Passover, a time when the city was filled with pilgrims, and was thrown down in an attempt to force him to renounce his faith before the people. Miraculously surviving the fall, James continued to pray for his attackers, only to be stoned and finally beaten to death with a fuller's club. This brutal end not only marked the loss of a significant leader in the early church, but also underscored the dangerous intersection of faith and politics in Jerusalem. James the Less's leadership in the Jerusalem church and his martyrdom at the temple reflect the complexities of the early Christian mission, navigating the delicate balance between old and new, tradition, and revelation. His death highlights the growing tensions between the emerging Christian faith and the established Jewish religious authorities, tensions that would shape the trajectory of the church in its formative years. In remembering James the Less, we are reminded of the courage it takes to lead with conviction and compassion, to stand firm in one's beliefs even in the face of persecution, and to embody the teachings of Christ through both words and deeds. His legacy, though marked by tragedy, continues to inspire leadership that is rooted in faith, grounded in love, and unwavering in the face of adversity. Jude Thaddeus. Transitioning from the poignant leadership and tragic demise of James the Less, we explore the missionary endeavors of Jude, also known as Thaddeus. Jude's story is one of quiet determination and profound faith, characteristics that fueled his journey across regions steeped in ancient traditions and beliefs, notably in Syria. Unlike some of his fellow apostles, Jude's ministry often unfolded away from the limelight of the early church's more prominent figures, yet his impact on the spread of Christianity is no less significant. Jude's mission in Syria, a land rich with cultural and religious diversity, was marked by his fervent preaching of the gospel. In a region intersected by trade routes that connected the East and West, Jude encountered a mosaic of beliefs and practices. His epistle, though brief, provides insight into his theological perspective, emphasizing faith in Jesus Christ as the foundation for living a life of holiness and devotion amidst a world of moral challenges and false teachings. But you, dear friends, by building yourselves up in your most holy faith and praying in the Holy Spirit, keep yourselves in God's love as you wait for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ to bring you to eternal life. Jude 1:20-21. The culmination of Jude's ministry, however, was intertwined with that of another apostle, Simon the Zealot. Tradition holds that Jude and Simon joined forces in their missionary work, a partnership that would ultimately lead them to face martyrdom together. Their mission took them far and wide, but it was in Persia where they would make their final stand for their faith. Facing fierce opposition from Zoroastrian priests who saw the spread of Christianity as a direct threat to their religious hegemony, Jude and Simon were relentless in their preaching of the gospel. The account of their martyrdom is a testament to their unshakable faith. They were executed for their refusal to cease their missionary activities and for their unwavering commitment to the teachings of Jesus Christ. The manner of their deaths, often depicted as being sawn in half, symbolizes the brutal reality faced by those who dared to challenge the prevailing religious and cultural norms of their time. The story of Jude, Thaddeus, and his joint martyrdom with Simon underscores the collective mission of the apostles to spread the message of Christ, a mission that transcended individual backgrounds and previous beliefs, uniting them in a common cause that was worth their very lives. Their legacy is a powerful reminder of the cost of discipleship and the transformative power of the gospel to forge bonds of unity and purpose among its most ardent followers. In reflecting on Jude's ministry and his ultimate sacrifice alongside Simon, we are reminded of the far-reaching impact of their witness, a witness that continues to inspire believers to live out their faith with courage and conviction, no matter the cost. Their stories, though marked by suffering and sacrifice, celebrate the triumph of faith and the enduring hope of the gospel, a beacon of light in a world often shrouded in darkness. Simon the Zealot was an apostle distinguished by his fervent zeal for the gospel and his extensive missionary journeys. Simon's epithet, the Zealot, suggests a passionate intensity in his faith and actions, a zeal that propelled him across diverse and challenging landscapes to proclaim the message of Jesus Christ. Unlike the more detailed accounts of some apostles, the Bible offers scant details about Simon's life and work. Yet early Christian tradition fills the canvas of his apostolic mission with vibrant strokes. Simon's zeal is indicative of his deep commitment to the cause of Christ, a commitment that saw him traversing the vast reaches of the Roman Empire and beyond. Alongside Jude, Simon embarked on missions that took him to the edges of the known world, including the difficult terrains of Persia, where he faced the ultimate test of his faith. The manner of Simon's martyrdom is a stark testament to the dangers faced by the apostles in their missionary endeavors. Tradition holds that in Persia, Simon met a gruesome end, martyred by being sawn in half. This method of execution, horrific in its brutality, signifies the extreme opposition encountered by the apostles as they challenged entrenched religious systems and cultural norms with the revolutionary message of the gospel. Simon's death by sawing, while profoundly tragic, underscores the transformative power of the gospel to inspire such unwavering commitment and sacrifice. Hebrews 11, though not specifically mentioning Simon, speaks to the faith and perseverance of God's people, who were tortured, refusing to accept release so that they might rise again to a better life. Hebrews 11:35. Simon's martyrdom embodies this scriptural principle, reflecting a faith so profound that it embraced death with the hope of resurrection and eternal life. Simon the Zealot's missionary zeal and his tragic yet triumphant death remind us of the cost of discipleship and the enduring impact of the apostolic mission. His story, interwoven with that of Jude and the other apostles, paints a compelling portrait of the early church's challenges and triumphs. It highlights the apostles' collective commitment to spreading the teachings of Jesus, often at great personal risk, driven by a zeal for the gospel that knew no bounds. In commemorating Simon's life and ministry, we are invited to reflect on our own zeal for the gospel and the lengths to which we are called to go in living out and sharing our faith. Simon's journey encourages us to persevere in our mission, fortified by the knowledge that our labor in the Lord is not in vain, and inspired by the ultimate sacrifice of those who laid down their lives for the gospel, ensuring its message would echo through the ages. Matthias was an apostle who joined the 12 under unique circumstances. Matthias's story begins after a moment of profound betrayal and loss within the early Christian community, the defection and subsequent death of Judas Iscariot. In the wake of Judas's departure, it became necessary to restore the number of apostles to 12, a symbolic completion of the group that Jesus had originally called. The Acts of the Apostles recounts this pivotal moment, highlighting the community's reliance on divine guidance in choosing Judas's successor. So they nominated two men, Joseph called Barsabbas, also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed, "Lord, you know everyone's heart. Show us which of these two you have chosen to take over this apostolic ministry, which Judas left to go where he belongs." Then they cast lots, and the lot fell to Matthias, so he was added to the 11 apostles. Acts 1:23-26. Matthias's selection as an apostle is noteworthy not only for the manner in which it was conducted, with prayer and casting of lots, but also for what it signifies about the early church's understanding of apostolic authority and continuity. Matthias, having been with Jesus from the baptism by John to the ascension, was not a newcomer to the teachings and miracles of Christ. Rather, he was deeply rooted in the life and ministry of Jesus, prepared to carry forward the mission entrusted to the apostles. Though the biblical record of Matthias's missionary activities is sparse, early Christian traditions provide glimpses into his dedication and the breadth of his evangelistic efforts. It is said that Matthias labored with zeal and perseverance, spreading the gospel in Cappadocia and the Caspian Sea region, areas fraught with challenges yet fertile ground for the message of salvation. The culmination of Matthias's dedication to proclaiming the gospel was his martyrdom. According to tradition, Matthias met his end by stoning, a fate that he bravely faced for the sake of his faith. This manner of death, while echoing the martyrdom of other apostles and early Christians like Stephen, underscores the perilous conditions under which the apostles worked to spread the teachings of Christ. Matthias's martyrdom is a testament to his unwavering commitment to the apostolic mission, a mission he embraced fully from the moment of his divine selection. Matthias, though often overlooked, embodies the spirit of dedication and perseverance that defined the apostolic age, his life and martyrdom serving as a capstone to the remarkable narratives of those who laid down their lives for the gospel. Theological significance and legacy. Of the 12 apostles, as we reflect upon the narratives of the apostles' missions, their unwavering faith and the ultimate sacrifices they made, we delve into the profound theological significance that their martyrdoms hold within the Christian tradition. Each apostle's story, culminating in a testament of blood, serves as a powerful affirmation of their faith in Jesus Christ, a faith so deep and unshakable that not even the threat of death could sway their commitment. The martyrdoms of the apostles are not merely historical footnotes. They are foundational to the identity and mission of the church. As Tertullian, an early Christian writer, famously said, "The blood of the martyrs is the seed of the church." This profound observation encapsulates the paradoxical truth that the church grew and flourished from the very acts intended to destroy it. The apostles' willingness to face death for the sake of the gospel became a compelling witness to the resurrection power of Jesus Christ, drawing many to the faith and strengthening the resolve of early Christians facing persecution. The theological significance of these martyrdoms lies in their vivid demonstration of the gospel's transformative power. The apostles, transformed by their encounters with the risen Christ, were propelled by a vision of the kingdom of God that was worth every earthly loss, including their lives. Their deaths echo the sacrificial love of Jesus, who laid down his life for the salvation of humanity, and they embody the call to take up one's cross and follow him, Matthew 16:24. In their martyrdom, the apostles participated in the sufferings of Christ, bearing witness not only to his death, but to the hope of his resurrection. The legacy of the apostles' sacrifices continues to resonate deeply in the modern Christian faith. Their stories inspire courage and steadfastness in the face of trials and persecution. They remind believers of the cost of discipleship and the call to live out the gospel with boldness and conviction, regardless of the circumstances. The apostles' lives and deaths challenge us to consider the depth of our own faith in Jesus Christ and our willingness to stand firm in that faith, even when faced with opposition or hardship. Their martyrdoms, while marking the end of their earthly journeys, marked the beginning of a legacy that would shape the course of history. Through their faithfulness unto death, the apostles laid the foundations of the church, and through the church's witness, the message of the gospel continues to spread across the globe.